skate there with them starting when I was just 3 years old. Right away, I knew I wanted to skate in the Olympics. I trained with the coach, Robin Wagner, and also started taking ballet. But before I had taken up any of those, I was doing violin. Some people said I had too much going on and that I should have given up violin. But I love violin and skating, so I did not give either of them up. What I did have to give up was a lot of my free time, and eventually I gave up some of my friends. In 1998, the world began to notice me because I had won the U.S. Junior Figure Skating Championships at the age of 12. It helped that my family had a sports championship can-do attitude. My dad was a star hockey player at Cornell and taught me the determination, patience, and responsibility that were needed to succeed in a competitive sport. I remained hardworking for years and soon qualified for the World Championships. In 2001, I took the bronze medal, finishing behind Irina Slutskaya and Michelle Kwan. A year later, in 2002, I took the ice as bravely as I could to compete in the Olympics in Salt Lake City. This became an amazing and unforgettable moment in my life. I even surprised myself when I won this gold medal. It was a dream come true for me. I was just 16, and that year most people thought Michelle Kwan would win. Also a great competitor, Michelle Kwan went on to become a professional skater touring the world, like so many other skating teams. But pro skating was not a path I chose. Instead, the year after I won the gold medal, I stopped skating. Although I certainly felt grateful and surprised to have won the Olympics, and it is a moment in my life I worked very hard for and will remember always, I also knew I couldn't do it forever. I decided to go to Yale, and I graduated with a BA in American Studies. Now I live in Colorado, and I'm working on a book about female figure skaters. I continue to play the violin, and I do still like to skate for fun. Oh, speaking of that, I'm off to the rink right now. Bye!